Taurus the Bull is unique in that it is one of Ptolemy's original 44 constellations. It is also the 17th largest constellation of the 88. Aldebaran is the brightest star in Taurus and makes up the red eye of the bull. Its Arabic name is Truefaller, as it is in pursuit of Pleiades. Beta Alnath makes up the horn of Taurus, and it is the budding one, the tip of the horn. At the bottom of the constellation lie a grouping of six stars, which make up the hooves of the bull. On the bottom left is Zeta, spectral type B43 star, which is 417 light years away. In the constellation Pleiades lies Alcyone, otherwise known as Eta. It is 368 light years away. At the heart of the bull is Lambda. This is a spectral type B35 star, and it is 379 light years away. The constellation Taurus, which is a member of the zodiac, is visible in the winter months in the northern hemisphere and in the southern hemisphere during the summer months. Mythology for the constellation Taurus dates back to the Bronze Age, with multiple meanings and contexts ascribed to it depending on which culture or heritage you look at. Back in 1940, cave paintings were discovered in southern France, which tell a story using both the constellations Taurus and Orion, dating the bull even further back in history. These paintings depict the two engaged in battle. The grouping of stars which sit atop Taurus's back has also been equally important to the mythology of Taurus. In fact, some would say that they are key to understanding this constellation's purpose. Ancient Mesopotamian culture states that this cluster of stars are the seven sons of Ishtar, the goddess of love, and that by praying to them, one could help ward off demons. The bull itself was sent by Ishtar to vanquish Gilgamesh, the warrior king, after he had spurned her advances. Alas, Taurus was vanquished by Gilgamesh and his companion, Enkidu. These stone inlays depict the epic battle of Taurus being defeated by Gilgamesh and Enkidu. According to Greek mythology, the stars atop Taurus's back are the Pleiades, the seven daughters of the Titan Atlas. Once Atlas was forced to carry the earth upon his back, Orion then took it upon himself to pursue his daughters. In order to appease their father, Zeus turned the daughters into doves, then finally turned them to stars, where they ride upon Taurus's back to this day in an effort to escape Orion. Among the notable features that lie within Taurus is the Crab Nebula. It is a pulsar wind nebula, emitting pulses ranging from gamma rays to radio waves. Discovered by modern astronomer John Beavis in 1731, it is the first astronomical object to be entered into Messier's catalog. Although this nebula is believed to be a remnant of supernova documented by astronomers back in 1054, it is the first deep space object connected to historical supernova explosions. This nebula lies 6,500 light years from the Sun. Another cool feature of Taurus are the two colliding galaxies. Star-forming galaxy NGC 410, which is the bluer galaxy to the left, is a spiral galaxy filled with young blue stars. NGC 1409 is the lenticular galaxy to the right. The notable black line between the two galaxies is where the gas is being sucked from 1409 to 1410. These galaxies may be moving relatively slow, but in 200 million years, they will merge into one. Within the star cluster Pleiades are contained nine of the brightest stars. These stars are the seven sisters of Greek mythology: Alcyone, Celaeno, Electra, Maia, Merope, Stirrup, and Taygeta. These are hot luminous B-class stars that are relatively young, and they are all within 390 to 460 light-years from our solar system. It is believed that this cluster of stars has 250 million years left in its lifespan. The other star cluster within Taurus is Hades. This is believed to be the five daughters of the Titan Atlas and half-sisters to Pleiades. This is an open star cluster and the nearest open star cluster to the Sun. The brightest star in Hades, combined with Aldebaran, make up the Bull's Head. Another notable feature of Taurus is the Crystal Ball Nebula, which is a large planetary nebula first discovered by William Herschel in November of 1796. It is a gaseous cloud which surrounds a close binary star. The Merope Nebula is a diffuse reflection nebula in the Pleiades cluster. It surrounds the star Merope. It is a bright nebula which is 440 light years distant from our solar system and was first discovered by astronomer Wilhelm Tempel. When it all comes together, the constellation Taurus is seen to be a very important constellation to the history of man, since it is recorded in so many cultures and histories. Whether he is helping the Pleiades sisters run from Orion, or bringing the sons of Ishtar to destroy Gilgamesh, Taurus is always a helping figure. He always plays a key supporting role to the story. In real life, Taurus also served as a guide, as he helped sailors mark the sun's location during the spring equinox. Taurus continues to have an impact upon our culture to this day, and he will for time to come.